What's up, Dream Team? It's a girl, Nick, and I'm here and I'm back again with another new and improved video, guys. So today I will be doing a hair routine video. This routine is not my fixed routine. This is just a general routine that I typically do. But like, it's not consistent every time I decide to do a hair routine. But guys, you'll see that I have already washed my hair, given that I have my hair towel on my head. And that's one fact or tip I want to give you guys, which is, number one, never, ever, ever, ever try to dry your hair with a regular drying towel that you would dry your body with, because it causes fizz, it causes like breakage and all a bunch of different stuff, and you don't need that happening. So what you need to do is go to your nearest Walmart, Family Dollar, or hair supply store and get you a turby twist. That's what this one called. I don't know if there's other name brands towels that you probably would find in those stores that I name off, but for sure you'll get a turby twist in a Walmart or Family Dollar or wherever your nearest beauty supply store is to wherever you live. So yeah, that's what you want to do, because the hair towels are actually made of microfibers that helps with anti-frizz. You don't get any frizz dealing with these kind of towels, and these towels also help with sucking up a lot of the water. And I would know, because I've had this towel for long enough, probably a year or a year and a half, and I never got any fizzing and stuff. I always have my hair like almost close to dry, actually dealing with these towels and not having to deal with any excess issues that a regular towel would typically give. But I ain't gonna get too much into that, guys. I just wanted to give you a little bit of knowledge on that, using regular towel and how my little experiences is going with dealing with the hair towel versus, you know, dealing with a regular towel. Or one more item you could use if you don't have the money for a hair towel, or if you don't have a hair towel currently right now, you want to go get a nice big t-shirt that is cotton and you want to use that and tie up your hair. That would also help avoid you having to deal with the frizzing and any other breakage, or you know, anything that would typically harm your hair whilst you using a regular towel, you know. And a cotton towel will be like a hair towel and soak up a lot of the water more than a regular towel would. So yeah, so there you have it, guys. You could either use a hair towel that is of microfibers in it, or you could use a cotton t-shirt. But anyways, I ain't gonna run on too much with that. So make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, turn on your post notification so you can get notified every time I post a brand new video. And make sure share this video with your family and friends and tell them to come over to the Dream Family if they haven't already. Yep. But as you can see in the back of me, I have a Kona blow dryer. But my blow dryer is actually here on the table with me because I'm actually sitting at my beauty table, my beauty vanity table, and I have, you know, mirror and lights. It's where some of the light coming from in the front of me, and you know I have my light on my above my head. So the first thing I want to do before I take this hair towel off, and you guys see the mess underneath there, I'm gonna show you guys how to make a white mix. And when I say white mix, it's because I typically use in white products. And I don't mean like race, I mean like color, you know, like color. But anyways, yeah, so I'm gonna be showing you guys this mix that I would make to help with moisturizing my hair, help to deal with breakage, and help to deal with growth. Three basic and important things. Okay, yeah. So the products I will be using is the Cantu Leave-In Conditioner, the Cantu Daily Moisturizer, the Vitamin E All by Hollywood Beauty, and the S-Curl No Drip. And if you guys want to add another set of oil, like olive oil, castor oil, carrot oil, coconut oil, whatever it is, you could add that in the mix, or you can get you some 7 essential oils by which brand that is. I have no idea what brand that is, but when I do eventually get up in this video to probably go in the bathroom to get something, I will bring the original bottle for the oil. So that is what you're going to put in the mixture. So you can put it in a cup, you know, a plastic cup where you could dispose it easily. And you want to go in with the thick products first, and then you put like the things like the oil and the S-Curl at last. But I don't think it might make a difference which one you decide to put in first, but usually I put the thick products in, like, you know, with this kind of consistency, because they much, you know, difficult to deal with. So depends on how much hair you have, you want to put like you could put 2 scoops, or you can put 3 or 4 scoops, depends on how much hair you have, like I said, because everybody hair length not the same, you know, that's one thing, everybody hair is not the same length, and 2, everybody hair is not the same hair type. So for people who have like low porosity hair, you know, it takes you longer to get your hair wet. It takes you longer to really get the hair moisturized. And so it requires a lot of product. For people who have high porosity hair, I suggest you don't use a lot of this product. You use probably half of the amount I use. I put 4 scoops inside here already. So you could put 2 if you have high porosity here, so your hair would not have a lot of buildup. And if you have short hair, you would put 2 in there also, because you don't want to put the amount as someone who have a lot of hair on their head or long hair. Because I say a lot of hair on your head because you could have short hair and you could have a lot of hair on your head, so you could still put a lot. But if you have short hair and you don't have a lot of hair, meaning like your hair's not thick, you don't need to put a lot. You see what I'm saying? But it's just my suggestion. because you don't want to go ahead and have a bunch of build up on your hair. You just wanted to get it in, get it going, get it moisturized, but you don't want the product to be so heavy that it's dropping back out your hair all over your clothes and stuff like that, or you're making your hair so white looking. So with the daily moisturizer, I already let like 2 drizzles in. You can put up to 2, or you can put up to 3, because this is a very liquidy product and you don't want to put a lot of this in there because you have leave-in conditioner. You just want to add a good much to a little in it, and you want to, you know, mix it so that can be in there, because the two of them is the same brand, you know. They're not the same exact product, but you already have a lot of leave-in conditioner going in. So I just don't think it makes sense to add a lot of the daily oil moisturizer in it. And you also gonna use like this S-Curl drip in there, which is another kind of liquidy product. So you wanna put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So you could let it drip in there like 20 times, literally. And so it'll look, oh geez, it'll look like that. And you want to mix it in there first before you put the oils in, so everything can be evenly in the mix, because this leave-in conditioner is kind of thicker than the other product. So you just want to mix it, and then you want to come in with your oils and probably drip it in there like 1, 2, 3. Do not go past 3, really, because if you, the more you add, the more oily the product will become. So you just want to put 3 drips in there just to get enough of each oils in there, or you could put 2 and then you want to mix it, because if you start pouring a lot of that oil in there, I'm telling you, even though the leave-in conditioner is thick and the other products is a liquidy thick base, because I don't know how else to describe that, it's a possibility that your hair can still come out very oily and shiny. That might sound good, but when it comes to at night time, when you go to rest your head on your pillow, you don't want the oils oozing onto your pillow, and then you have to now deal with the oils getting into your face, and then you're trying to figure out why your face is breaking out. So that is one of my little secrets on how to get a moisturizer mix, white moisturizer mix, because they could be different colors, I guess, depending on what kind of products you're using. So, you know, some products can be moisturizers or whatever it may be, and it can have some type of color to it. So that's why I specified. Oh, so yeah, this is how it looking. It should still look thick after you have already done it. If it don't look thick like this, then you ain't doing it right. You're pouring too much or whatever it is in there. And in this video, you guys will be seeing me blow dry my hair and try this product, which is the Infinity Pro Porcupine Brush. Now, I don't have no sponsor dealing with the towel, down to the products I use in, or this brush. But I just trying to show you guys what I use on my hair, because I know it could be a little bit frustrating when you see people post a video with them using products and they don't say what the name of the products is for you to even try to say, let me try it on my hair, especially when you're still in the process of discovering what hair product for your hair. So this what I will be using whilst I using the blow dryer to give me a blow. Now I've never tried this before. As you can see, the package is still new and it has not been touched. So I'm going to also show you guys on camera how this would turn out for my hair, so you can know if you should use it, especially if you have my hair type, because my hair type is difficult to keep up with and to take care of. Also guys, this is very important. Do not put heat on your hair without using a heat protector. This brand is very good. I've been using it for quite a while, you know, from a younger age. My beautician used to put this on my hair. Well, sometimes she would have the pink one. I don't know if the pink or the red one make any difference, but you want to use Fantasia hair polisher, heat protector, and straightening serum. You want to use this one. So go in the store and get you this exact one, because I never had any issues with this. And you could also add this in the same mix, because I saw this wouldn't interfere with the product which you already mix. Besides, you put in this in your hair anyhow along with this, so why not drip some in there? Just make sure you got good much in there for this product to be still, you know, and there's not hidden. So you want to put enough in there and mix it good so it can protect your hair like it should. So that is the last product I would add in there. I promise you it ain't a whole lot. It's just leave-in conditioner, a daily moisturizer, an S curl so it can help you have your pretty curls, and oils, and then heat protector, because heat protector have to be in the mix. Alright, so now I'm going to come back once I would have sectioned my hair and add this product in my hair so the video don't be too long. Alright, I'm back training team. It's now, let me see, 10:46, and I probably start my hair like a little bit after 7, and I'm finally on the last section. I would have already sectioned my hair into 4 big sections, put the product on my hair, pre-section it again, like, you know, in halves, and clear out that half and blow dry it and using the brush, and do the next section and then blow dry the entire section and throw it in a plait. But you're about to see that process anyhow, so I'm gonna show you guys the reason why the heck it would take long for someone like me to blow dry my hair and make sure I clear out properly. Because reason one, my hair is thick, I have a lot of hair. 2, my hair is getting out of pretty quick. Like, it might not look like it on camera, but you guys both to see how really not up it is. Okay, so let's get into the video. Okay, so using the product I show you guys much early in the video, you're going to scoop it on your hand and then massage it into the hair and make sure you get the ends, because the ends is the oldest part of the hair. When I do the detangling process, I detangle my hair with a YT comb, and when it comes to dealing with the locks, I use a rat tail comb. You guys gonna see what I mean by YT comb and rat tail comb in a minute. I just want to make sure I get as much of this product as possible onto my hair, and then I'm gonna section it. And you would use it to generally, you know, detangle the hair as much as possible. Ooh. And you guys wanna make sure section your hair into smaller sections. And each sections, rather than trying to deal with the whole thing, especially if you have a lot of hair and your hair tangles a lot like mine, and on top of that you're tender-headed, so you want to make sure do the best at sectioning the hair and detangling it carefully so you can have a less painful experience and a smooth experience when it comes to the blow drying process. And yeah, so I use rat tail only if I have knots and if I try to use it to section the hair once it's like untangled or something. And I have good results. As you guys can see, I really like how it turned out. It really helped with making the hair more straight, soft, and easier to deal with. So I'm going to show you guys right now. So I'm going to put on blow dry and you guys gonna see. Guys, so this is generally how it should look, especially with my hair type. It ain't gonna get no straighter than that, but you see, like, it's scratched and it's more easier to comb through. It's actually looking thinner and it's great as possible. So that's good results. And I'm gonna twist this, get this out the way so I can deal with the other section, and then go back to putting more product on the both of them once I finish drying it and whatnot. And then dry the whole thing generally so I can brush the brush back through. And then we're gonna put a big flat machine and then I'll be done. So yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna add more product to this section before I start detangling it. Hey guys, all right, I think I'm done with this blow drying process finally, and it's now 11:09, so that's good. I get like a good couple minutes before it reaches 12 o'clock, which means it will be the next day. Okay, I started my hair this evening rather than this morning because our house is going through renovation process, so I couldn't go ahead and say bathe because the water got turned off, so I couldn't say go bathe and wash my head already plus I was still sleepy and tired, so I wasn't going to force myself to do that either. So I decided to do schoolwork first so I could get that out of the way and then. Even when I clean it out. And now you guys see why I just have to put a lot of focus in it. Clearing it out so it could be as tangle free as possible, you know. Honestly, this section looks like it has more hair than the next side, but hey, I don't go nowhere but to my brother's school because I just have to do school pickup and drop off. And then I come home and focus on my schooling because I attend school online because my school, which is back in the Bahamas where I'm from, is still online. So as long as they online, I don't think it makes sense for me to move. And then they would have to transfer my credits, and I don't know how long that process would take. So I'm gonna just stay there while stay online, and then eventually I can move to school over here, because I am actually in my third year of college. Guys, if you don't know, yes, I'm a junior, so I'm proud of myself for coming this far. I still have one more year in my degree because I'm doing a bachelor's, and then your girl will be graduating with her first degree, and then I'm going to medical school because I want to be a doctor. I'm studying biochemistry. So yeah, but if the time comes where I'm having, where I have to go out and it's like somewhere, so Angela, you kind of wear your chin hair, then I'ma loose these out and probably just nicely brush my hair in one. I don't think I'm gonna add gel to it. But anyways, guys, I'm trying to make this video longer than it already is gonna be. So thank you guys for waiting for me to drop a video. I know it's probably been like 3 weeks now, I think. I don't think it's been a month yet, but like 3 weeks, I think. And that's because I honestly wasn't feeling good, so I couldn't post videos because my performance level wasn't great. My energy level wasn't great, but I recovered. I'm not 100% recovered because you can tell by my voice that I still have a little more recovery to do, but you will be seeing videos from me. I'm not gonna say how long it would take to get to drop videos, but I need you guys to be patient. I'm gonna drop as much as I can in a month. Maybe set a goal for 3 videos a month. But if I don't, please forgive me. School is gonna have me busy. I'm taking way more classes now than I did in the summer. In the summer, I only took 2 classes, but because I was only allowed to take 2 classes in the summer, that's just how it is with the college, or with our college, if it ain't our college that is too loud. So I'm taking 5 classes, and you know, sometimes 5 classes carry on like 8 classes. So if you guys in college, you definitely can relate to what I'm talking about. But anyways, guys, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, turn on your post notifications to get notified every time I post another video. Guys, make sure to share this video with your family and friends, and tell them to join the Dream Family, because we are the winning team around here, and I will be dropping more bangers and lit videos, okay? So guys, let me know in the comment section down below what is the next video you guys want to see me do. You guys watch my video, but you guys never really is telling me what videos y'all want to see to keep y'all entertained. You know, I try to keep y'all entertained. I try to let y'all get to know me as well and see what's going on in my life, you know, a bit. Because I'm going to be dropping every single thing about myself on here. You know, a level of privacy still need to be contained or maintained, whatever the word you want to use. But I hope you guys get where you're coming from. But anyways, we are out, Dream Team. Bye.